But first, let's kick off with the market. A very positive day for oil and gas companies. Babajide Sholanke, Research and Strategy Analyst at FSD Merchant Bank, is standing by to give us some thoughts on the day's trade. Thank you so much, Jide, for joining us. Clearly, there's a very positive sentiment for petroleum marketing and oil exploration companies with Seplat. We see all of them leading the market forward this today. Your thoughts on the implications of that Oando transaction announcement for that sector?
Thank you, Wale. For the whole marketing sector, as you rightly mentioned, excluding the oil exploration company, which Oando and Seplat clearly stand in, and Cornwall and MRS are kind of half of it for now, is that what has just happened is that you know that IOCs are divesting from oil assets, some IOCs are divesting from oil assets in Nigeria, and there's an increasing capacity by Nigerian firms to acquire these assets and take the lead in driving the Nigerian economy, particularly the oil and gas sector. What has happened clearly for Oando is that now Oando is going to have enhanced earnings, you're going to have improved and bigger earnings. However, shareholders must be careful and understand that there's a significant increase in the debt level of the company, and because of this first charge on earnings of the company by debt holders, the shareholders should begin to consider asking for increasing returns from the company, which I believe will happen anytime soon. Anyway, for Seplat as well.
Okay, go ahead. The point you're making on Seplat.
For Seplat, Seplat 2 is clearly, showing indication that they need, of course, they indicated that they needed to acquire more assets. They measured those assets that they needed to acquire, and one of the reasons why they came to the market to raise funds was one of that. And of course, hopefully, if the minister has cleared Oando, so definitely along the line, for soon, we will see that they will clear Seplat as well. Seplat 2 will join, increase its oil assets, which it will acquire from the IOC that disposed it. For Cornwall, interestingly, Cornwall has shown very increasing profitability. If you check its Q1, Q2, Q2 2013 figures, of course, the full year figures are not yet out. But historically, the company releases that full year earnings between July and August, and it's expected that going to be a significant increase in earnings, of course, and the trickle down in terms of dividend payment. So that is driving Cornwall shares. For MRL, I think just the bandwagon effect from the Cornwall and the Seplat and the Oando fallout.
Right, Jide, very quickly, how long do you think the market is going to celebrate this Oando transaction? And we're seeing very positive sentiment for stocks in that space. Do you think this rally is going to extend into next week?
Yeah, I think it will extend to next week, but of course, with some intermittent profit taking, for particular stocks, maybe corn oil, as we've seen in recent time, there was increases and increasing share price, and some people taking profit, and MRS oil. For Oando, I think it will go on. For Seplat, I think it will kind of slow down as well. But for Oando, I expect it to go into next week, as we have improved earnings. Of course, the release of the Q2 results will show us clearly the further direction, what should we expect going forward from Oando.
Definitely, there will be a lot of interest in those Q2 numbers. We'll be following that. Thank you so much, Babajide Sholanke, a Research and Strategy Analyst at FSD Merchant Bank, wrapping up the latest news in Nigeria's equities markets. And of course,